So we are 1 week into the control tour. We've done 6 gigs, and it's already been an incredible adventure. We started 1 week ago today in Buffalo, New York, all coming together, a whole new team, 18 people on 2 buses, going across the eastern coast of America with our control tour. We had a surprise in Buffalo because of the Hurricane Sandy that swept through the east coast last week, so our first gig was actually canceled. But we didn't want to start the tour off that way, so we got everybody together in the hotel room and actually played music and had about 15 or 20,000 people, many of them from the East Coast, locked into their houses, tuning in and hearing us play music. Not the way we thought we were going to start, but an incredible start. We had a lecture that day in Buffalo. Our first one, we were a little bit nervous, but it also came together very well. The students were very receptive. They were asking lots of questions about business and how to get into this whole genre that we're involved in. The next day we went to Syracuse, and that was really incredible. Very small club, and you really felt that we were connecting with a whole new audience.
What he is doing right now is going to affect the whole movement, and people will realize what other kinds of music and dark tones and stuff is really out there, and what's possible through technology and through what Tractor and the technology that he's using today.
Every day has been completely different. You know, in Berklee College of Music in Boston, we had a very deep intellectual audio engineering group of students, asking about compression and how we mix for the club. How do we get, music that sounds great to listen to, but also has impact with bass? Actually that question came up a couple of times. In Philadelphia, we met with our friend Josh Wink and had a great hangout. Another thing, we're traveling through we're working most of the time, but to see some friends and continue the conversation of, what is beyond EDM on the bus has been very insightful.
Rich surrounds himself with a great group and a forward-minding think tank of people with great visions and great beliefs, and the amount of organization that has come to do all this tour is just awesome and amazing.
Actually, up until Friday, we didn't even know if New York was going to happen. Unfortunately, the lecture in New York was canceled because of Sandy. NYU, the whole university, was closed down. But the club gig at Webster Hall was confirmed Friday night. We arrived in New York on Saturday afternoon, and you could feel the energy in the air. I think people really needed some way to celebrate and to kind of let all those emotions out. After going through, I think, 3 or 4 or 5 pretty hard days in the New York area. I get goosebumps now thinking about it. We had an incredible, incredible party. What we call a super bomb. Ian killed it. Teeny, one of Dice's label artists, played. Just before I was coming on, I was like, how am I going to take it to another level? Because Dice was destroying it. Traveling the Eastern Coast, meeting and talking, inspiring, being inspired, and reaching out to the next generation. Control beyond EDM. We continue.